I'm Tria Ninja Hen. I write web fiction and I do animations, like the intro you are going to see now. This series is about copying books. I want to advance my level in writing. I want to become a better writer and better author. Yeah, so I decided to make this series. I will copy some masterpiece, what I see as a masterpiece, and will analyze what I learned from it, or what there is to learn from it, or what impressed me, what didn't impress me, or just what approach the author did take. Hey, welcome to episode 2. So we left off on the first paragraph of Robert Heinlein's, I pronounce the name the German way, I believe it's a German way. I don't know how you English people pronounce Heinlein, and a part of me don't want to know. Starship Troopers. I can't tell you how much the first few sentences impressed me. You've got this quote, "Come on, you apes, you want to live forever." Immediately I asked, do I want to live forever? And in my case, the answer is yes. But you've got a sergeant who asks the soldier, do you want to live forever? I read a lot of Chinese literature, and the sergeants or the leaders or whoever or just everyone, they start a battle with kill. And then everybody repeats, kill, 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 kill. That's quite something different to start a battle. I think that the quote is from the start of a battle. Come on, you apes. You want to live forever. I feel it's powerful. Let's leave it like this. Then we've got the actual chapter. So the MC gets the shakes before a drop. We don't know yet what's a drop, but I don't know any context where the word drop is positive. So we've got something negative. And we know it because he gets the shakes for it. So he says, injections, so injections against shakes is a bit peculiar. Then hypnotic preparation is peculiar as well. Then we've got another info, the ships. We are on a ship. Psychiatrist has to say something on our health, okay. And he tells me that it isn't fear, it isn't anything important. It's just the trampling of an eager racehorse on the starting gate. And I mean, that's great. From this first paragraph, we've got so many information about the MC, about the world, even about the time maybe. About the MC, he is someone who starts shaking before something which seemingly everybody is afraid. I come to the conclusion that everybody is afraid because they have preparations for it. Anti-angst preparation, anti-fear preparation, hypnotic and injections. But he isn't afraid. No, he is eager. And that alone paints a heroic picture on the first paragraph. Great, just great. Then we've got the information about the world, that there are injections, and there are hypnotics, and that there are psychiatrists, and that there are ships. The whole thing is familiar, but a bit strange, because, yeah, like I said before, I don't know about injections against fear and hypnotic preparation. I mean, it's more common in the last few years than it was ever before, I believe. Like many athletes get hypnotic preparations. I can't judge what significance hypnotism had in the past. There were a lot of charlatans, and there was a trend in the 19th century about mesmerism and being mesmerized. Yeah, let's leave it like that. So, great first paragraph, really great. I'm very impressed. So, let's look a bit deeper into the language. We've got the first sentence starts with I, the second as well. Then the next sentence starts with the subject as well. So, we've got three sentences in a row that are starting with the subject. One very short sentence, the next a bit longer, the third one very long. I mean, I believe Grammarly would complain about it. Let's check this. Oh dear. One paragraph, seven alerts. Ooh. The performance score is really low as well. I believe you write a bit more and then look again at Grammarly. And yeah, this end thing is really bothering me with Grammarly. I just do what Grammarly says because I think it knows it better than me. But it kind of validates me that Heinlein doesn't do this strange commas. Alrighty. I copied 2,470 words, and that's only half of chapter one. Oh dear. I don't know. My chapters are around 2,000 words. Is this too low? I dropped the text into Grammarly. Yeah, the word drop, I wrote it a lot of times in the last hour. I haven't looked at the watch, but I believe I needed over an hour to copy it, but I'm not sure about it. There are 77 alerts and overall score of 89. Readability, word lengths below average, sentence lengths above average, much above average. I can agree to this. There are some really long sentences. Readability score 78. Unique words 33%. Rare words 35%. Both below average. Your text is likely to be understood by a reader who has at least 7th grade education, age 12. That's the evaluation I get the most often as well. Sometimes 12, sometimes 13. So let's look at the alerts in detail. This is okay. This is wrong from Grammarly. This really is totally okay. I can't judge the comma. The most of these are comma alerts, and I can't judge them at all. I've got the injections, of course. I would say I would add a comma here, but only me. And punctuation is not my strong suit. Racehorse, this may just an age thing, that nowadays we write it together and he chose, when this time they wrote apart. Off duty, he wasn't bad. Yeah, I would add a comma there too. But right now, comma, he was on duties. These remove tautology is getting on my nerves, because this time it's totally alright to use own neck because you want to emphasize that it's your own neck and just not your neck, but your very, very own neck that is in peril. So, what says Grammarly about this? Possibly wordy sentence, yeah. The sentence is fairly short. I would say that's totally alright. Downcheck is one of the military slang terms. Yeah, unclear accent. This is one of the things I complained a lot about Grammarly, that all these commas in front of ends, I'm really not sure whether Grammarly puts them on the right place. I have to Google that topic in the near future. hard to read sentence, okay. Stylistic decision, I would say. Same with this, actually. And this is slang. That's not that dirt, but dirt. I like this sort of military speak. I believe Heinlein conveyed this very good. Make contact would be probably the better way here. There we've got a word repetition, and I'm really astonished that it's capsule and not drop. Okay, let's just check how often the word drop. Yeah, 19 times in one chapter. I mean, heaven and hell. Okay, capsule 15 times, good. Yeah, comma, comma, comma. This is another ridiculous feature. Blah, blah, blah is often overused. Oh, no, it appears repeatedly in this text. Can you get out faster? Yeah, I mean, this is style. But I think Grammarly is right about all the commas at the beginning of the sentences. But who I am to know this. Here's another word repetition. He uses a lot of ellipses, a ton of ellipses. And don't get me started on the hyphens. Passive voice, I believe 2 times in the whole 2,400 words. That's still less than I use. Mm-hmm. Lose some of the perfect formation in which it unloads. I believe this is wrong from Grammarly as well. Near zero. I noticed only very, very few adjectives. Yeah, to add to the fun. Okay, let's check on adjectives and adverbs. Silly question. I'm scared silly. Properly. You kill only. Privately. Quietly. This really, maybe? Another really? Gently, okay. Uncontrollably. Barely. Immediately. Precisely. Barely. Early. Suddenly. Weightlessly. Hardly. Quickly. Only. Another only. Properly. A pilot who puts you down properly is a pilot who's modern. Yeah. Unevenly, only, immediately. He uses as much immediately like me. Oh, this is one of my most used words. But a great way to start a sentence. To add to the fun, your ship lays. To add to the fun. Great. Firmly. Okay, this was it. Okay, I really can't say, but I think he doesn't use much adjectives. So let's analyze how the sentences begin and how the time flows. This is me from 1 week later. In the meantime, I wrote a program to analyze sentence starters. Before we go over the program and the sentence starters, let me address the second issue, the flow of time in the first half of the chapter of Starship Troopers. We get a second-to-second analysis of the feelings and the happenings to the main character, so we've got a very slow flow of time. There were no time skips at all yet. Back to the sentence starters. I pasted the text of the first chapter in it, and first it analyzes the type of text. Is it a normal text? Is it a header? This logic doesn't function well at all. Is it a dialogue or is it a dialogue tag? It doesn't recognize all dialogue tags, so some sentences are marked for manual analysis. I have to go over them to look at them, whether they are dialogue tags or normal text. The next category is sentence starters. One are regular sentences with a subject, verb, rest. 1A is he, she, they, or the name of a character. 1B is this, that, these. 1C are sentences starting with you. Heinlein uses you not only in dialogues, but the first person narrator also addresses the audience directly with you. 2 are when or where, as sentences starting with where or when. 3A are verbs with ing, and 3B are sentences starting with to. It's not always verbs, but there can be other occasions where a sentence starts with to as well. 4 is an ED phrase, like buried under the grass. 5 are words with LI. 6 are conjunctions, connector words, like because. 7 are sentence starting with S or like. 8 question or prompts. 9 the rest. 9A dialogue stuff, yes, no, well. 9B dialogue, text structure, said he. The next category is the sentence length. I made 5 subcategories, one for very short sentences, less than 50 letters, one for less than 100, less than 200, less than 300, and category 5 is for over 300 letters. So I copied the stats of the first part of Starship Troopers. And stats are nice, but they don't speak for themselves if you have nothing to compare them to. So I added a few other books, like the first chapter of Harry Potter, the first chapter of my novel, because I want to compare my stats with the stats of the masters. Then Sherlock Holmes, The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes, the first chapter, Pride and Prejudice, the first chapter, and a Chinese web novel, the first chapter. M.H.G.A. Marshall, it was one of the Marshall Asura, I don't remember which one. But let's look at Starship Troopers first. Nearly half of it is dialogue. That astonished me, and compared with the other masterpieces, you can see that it even had the least dialogue among them. Sherlock Holmes has a whopping 70% dialogue, and Pride and Prejudice even more. Sentence starters, the most were regular sentences. Compared to the other books, really many sentences started with you. Only Pride and Prejudice had more, but they are mainly within the dialogue sections. When and where was significant as well. The yellow marked spots are the winner in the row. I haven't included MHG because it's not really a masterpiece. Okay, ATTV isn't a masterpiece as well, but it's my novel, so I wanted to see what stats stood out. Like, I started much more sentences with connector words than other novels. Good, now let's look at the sentences. First, I selected the normal sentences with a subject as starter. Of course, lots of sentences start with an I because of the choice of narrator. Next are the sentences starting with where or when, then suddenly nothing. Sentences with an ing phrase or with an to phrase, floating in darkness to add to the fun. 4 is missing at all, That's the at phrase, no at phrase in the text. Five are Lee words, presently he stepped out in front. Six are connector words, a lot of buts and some ends. These ends are closely to each other. Sentence 40, sentence 42, sentence 43, but it's a stylistic thing. Between them are always bumps, bump, and it jerks again, bump. But all these buts, I believe I would have substituted some for another word. Seven is as or like. Eights are prompts or questions. No questions here, at least not in the normal text. I believe in the dialogue we have some questions. And nine is the bloody rest. Let's only look at a normal text again. Off duty. I could add off duty, off as a where or when phrase. Yeah, I haven't decided how I handle some, none, one, these kinds of words. I've got a category for yes and well, but only if they're in dialogue. And numbers, many sentences start with numbers as well. Alright, we've got the sentence starters. We spoke about the relation between normal text and dialogue. Let's look at the length of the sentence. The most are short sentences, then middle sentences are there as well, another 40% if you add them. And then we've got a whole 8% of ultra-long sentences. If you compare it with the other book, you will see nearly nothing of this. I mean, I'm a short sentence writer because Grammarly is bitching at me for long sentences, and the translator writes short sentences as well because he learned it at school, I believe. And only the masters dare to write long sentences. We are looking at the long sentences, what they're about and how they're connected. Okay, we've got the first connection with an end, and while, another end, a hyphen, oh wow, next sentence, a hyphen, a who, a but, so big he had a comparison. By the way, this is the only description of persons in the whole chapter. The MC isn't described, the padre isn't described, all we know is a swarthy little man who looked like a clerk. That's the only description. No hair colors, no eye colors, no skin color. That's it. Great. I implemented Jenna Morassi's imperative that you always should describe skin color and the rest, and you always should describe the persons in your text, but I'm having a hard time with it. I mean, I'm just not a person's describer. We get a very good expression of Jelly, even without knowing swarthy little man who looked like a clerk. Alone from the dialogue he had with our MC and the other soldiers. He yelled at them a lot, and it was typical sergeant behavior in books. Next sentence. Hyphen, after, and now, another end, few other ends. Next sentence. Connection with end, and then a whoever. Here we've got an ED subordinate clause, barely subordinate clause. That, even if, never if, oh heaven help me. Good, let's leave it that we have some really, really long sentences. But Grammarly didn't complain about it. It has to be the hyphens. I want to show you another thing. One of the dialogues was really intense. It's the Petra hammering it down on Johnny. Johnny's the MC. Justice, Johnny, don't buy a farm. You know your job. Do it. Just do it. Don't try to win a medal. I thought this is really powerful. the short sentences, the short prompts right next to each other. I could really imagine him speaking intensively to Johnny. Don't buy a farm. Be reasonable. Don't be a hothead. At last, we're just looking about the whole text, if we find any patterns. Like, I see here that he mixed up the sentence length. There are short sentences, they get longer, they get shorter, they get longer, they get shorter. It isn't a whole block of ultra-long sentences, but he really does mix it up. The same with the sentence starters. Ah, here we've got a block of longer sentences. Yeah, I used this feature today for editing a chapter before uploading it, and it really highlighted some repetitions for me. Sentence starter. It's a thing that's fairly important to me. I look at my startings of my sentences when I write. I believe it's even more important for the audio part, but some primal region in your brain knows it if you repeat the same structure too often and it gets lulled to sleep by it. So this is a topic I will inspect in future as well. Okay, so we've got a short look at the sentences and at the grammar. I didn't think about is that it's written in the first person singular perspective, and my book is written in this third person perspective. And that's really one point that makes you want to copy another. Okay, on another point is, I mean, I'm literally breaking the copyright here because I copy a novel. I mean, I don't do it to sell it. I don't sell the novel, but I do a YouTube video about it, and the YouTube video is free, yes, but you can get copy strikes for it. So I have to think about ways to gray some things out. Most things. So if you see a lot of grayed out things or blurred out things, you know now the reason for it, because I don't want to get copyright strikes. I don't know how the literature books about literature books do this. I mean, I'm clearly stating what opus I'm discussing. I'm discussing Starship Troopers from Robert Heinlein. So I think it should be okay that I show sentences from it, but I think it's important that I don't show them in the right order and that I don't show all of them, so you will see grayed out thingies. Please comment on what aspect I should focus my analysis. If you missed some things on the grammar side or on the content side, or if I should condense it more. I haven't told you much about the content yet. First few sentences was to get an impression of the main character, and the rest was more to hammer it down that we're in a military situation, to get an impression of the military traditions in this universe, like that pilots are more likely to be female, and that a whole outfit jumps together, even the cooks. So we've got quite a bit of world building done as well. We've seen a bit of the MC and learned a bit about him, but only really the tiniest bit. Like, he's freshly promoted and he is afraid of drops. Whether he's afraid or not, it's up to debate, but he shakes before drops. And we've got a lot of technical knowledge about how the drop works. I think this is something the early sci-fi authors had to do or were fascinated by it, that they had to get a technical, like here with the G's. G's are for gravity. For someone who, if you don't read a sci-fi, so it's slang for gravity. But in general, I think it was interesting and I want to continue this series. I will definitely finish the chapter, but then I don't know if I will continue with this book. But now, let's finish this chapter and thank you for watching. Yeah, please leave comments. Comment on the things I asked a few more seconds ago and comment what other books I should to try instead of this book. I want it to be a third person perspective book. Bye bye. Okay, I have to add this. I should choose a newer book because of all the commas. I think really this is a problem because the book is older. Punctuation is not my strong suit, and therefore it is important that I choose a book to copy who has good punctuation. Yeah. Doesn't matter. I finished this book and we'll see. Not this book, this chapter. We'll see. Sorry. Ciao.